As 2020 started, the Glen Cove Downtown BID was excited to announce new events and new programs. We said goodbye to old friends and celebrated their retirement. Then our world changed into something we could not imagine. Our streets were empty, our businesses were closed. We advocated for funding for our small businesses. Then the sun started to shine as we worked together and learned how to do business in a different way. Our community came together in a peaceful way to support Black Lives Matter. We continued to make our downtown beautiful with flower baskets and banners. We initiated street closures so that our restaurants could extend outdoor dining. Our Downtown Sounds Committee never wants our downtown to be without music. So we created virtual Downtown Sounds. With this, we reached over 3,800 viewers with each concert from around the world, while safely keeping the music in our downtown streets. Now more than ever, we invested in more landscaping, more holiday decorations, to keep our downtown inviting and welcoming. How can we do more? Well, with the help of DPW, we lit up School Street. After 5 long months of being closed, we welcomed back our fitness businesses, and we celebrated in a big way by offering free fitness workouts in Village Square. We witnessed the completion of Village Square. We said hello to new neighbors and welcomed 5 new businesses to downtown. But nothing made us happier than when Santa came to downtown Glen Cove to celebrate the holidays with our community. We are Downtown Glen Cove. We are here, ready, and happy to serve you. It's been hard on local businesses in our downtown area, but the Glen Cove Downtown Business Improvement District has continued to promote support of the local economy and found ways to bring people safely downtown throughout the pandemic. Tonight, I will present an overview of what we did for the business district in 2020. We welcome guest speakers U.S. Congressman Tom Suozzi, Senator Jim Gorin, Legislator Delia DeRiggi-Whitton, and our Mayor Timothy Tenke. We will also honor 4 outstanding people for their dedication to our community over the course of the pandemic. Let me start by explaining what is the Business Improvement District, commonly known as the BID. The BID is a geographical business area in which property owners invest in their neighborhoods by self-funding. The BID provides services beyond those of the local municipality. The BID also acts as a liaison between businesses and City Hall. The BID's Board of Directors is made up of 8 downtown property owners, 3 downtown commercial tenants, 1 residential tenant, 3 appointed city officials that must include the controller. The Glen Cove Downtown BID has always advocated for our small businesses in downtown Glen Cove, but in this unprecedented year, it was our top priority. As Governor Cuomo issued his first directive ordering bars and restaurants to only offer takeout and delivery services, the BID visited every eatery in our downtown to make sure that they had a full understanding of the directive. We discussed how they may do business differently by using a third-party delivery service. This would not only allow eateries that did not offer delivery services to now have a means to do so, but it also stood for a marketing tool. Not knowing what would come next, the bid also complied the business personal contact information so that the bid was able to stay in contact with their members, to check on them, and to make sure they received valuable information pertaining to the pandemic and funding available. When Governor Cuomo ordered all non-essential businesses closed, the bid went out once again to make sure that all our businesses understood the new directives. The bid complied a list of businesses and eateries that were opened or temporary closed. These lists were updated on a daily basis and sent out through e-blast and social media. The bid actively joined every webinar, Zoom meeting, and conference calls to learn about the SBA loans and to continuously share this information with their small businesses. When it looked like many of our small businesses were being left out of the bid, businesses left out of the PPP loans, we found a contact with American Community Bank that helped over 38 downtown small businesses and bring in approximately $1.4 million of funding into our downtown. The bid's outreach efforts also served as a measure of moral support and comfort to business owners. The bid advocated for control over outrageous charges by third-party delivery services. The bid initiated street closures to allow our downtown eateries to extend outdoor dining. As the mayor of Glen Cove approved street closures for extended outdoor dining, the bid went to each eatery to make sure that all the correct information to apply for our outdoor dining and to participate in the extension of our outdoor dining street closures. This included getting the appropriate documents regarding the SLA license. The bid has also created a map to ensure that each participating eatery has a spot for their outdoor dining during street closures. The bid applied and received a grant from PSEG designed to help small businesses successfully adapt to changes caused by the pandemic. Through the PSEG grant, the bid purchased string lights that were strung up on School Street in an effort to illuminate the outdoor dining space and draw attention to our downtown. I just want to stop for a moment to just let you know, we do have videos and we are having a little bit of a technical difficulty. So if you don't see videos, I apologize. The bid is divided with four different committees: finance, marketing and economic development, special events, and capital improvements. Let's start off in finance. In 2020, the bid received $144,000 from the bid assessment, $1,000 in seasonal decor, $10,000 for NASA County grant, the City of Glen Cove Downtown Sound Partnership, $12,500, Downtown Sound Sponsorship, $6,000, Holiday Festival Sponsorship, $450, with a total revenue of $174,000. Now, what does the bid do with this revenue? The bid purchased over 65 flower baskets of rose begonias and hanging mizu. We continue to add flower arms for more hanging baskets. These flower baskets are hung and maintained by DPW and beautification. We replaced banner brackets and poles and hung Downtown Sound banners in the spring, summer, and fall. We doubled our budget on fall flowers and had over 1,000 mums and cabbages planted by Testa Landscaping. We provide seasonal autumn flowers and ornaments at wholesale prices for our members. We provide American flags and nautical flags that greet us as we enter downtown and are proudly raised by DPW. We had such a great response in decorating the lampposts in the downtown with he and she scarecrows that we added more this year. We purchased string lighting, and with the help of Vinnie Martinez and Mario Caldon, we lit up School Street. We partnered with DPW and beautification in decorating the streets for the holiday with decorations that the bid provides. Through sponsorship from American Paving and Masonry, we converted the police booth into a holiday cottage. We make sure litter, leaves, and weeds are removed from downtown walkways, and we hold a contract with Testa Landscaping to maintain the majority of the landscaping in the downtown area. Marketing and economic development. Marketing and economic development. We also create videos. Oh, I apologize. We promote and market our businesses through social media, reaching up to 10,000 people in their demographic group. In the last few years, we offered our businesses co-op advertising that allowed them to market their businesses at an affordable price. This year, the bid produced and purchased two commercials that aired for 6 weeks each on Channel 12 and Fios for a total of 650 aired commercials, highlighting our businesses and restaurants, reaching over 150,000 people each time it aired.
Embark on a journey around the world in downtown Glen Cove with our many diverse restaurants. Enjoy dining. Shop at our local stores. We are here, ready and happy to serve you. Embark on a journey around the world in downtown Glen Cove with our many diverse restaurants. Enjoy dining. Shop at our local stores. We are here, ready and happy to serve you. Embark on a journey around downtown Glen Cove.
We also create commercials for our downtown businesses free of charge for our businesses to have. We share these commercials on social media, and we also had an opportunity to include them in our virtual Downtown Sounds commercials. Please see an example of a commercial that we produced.
And I'm Mike Cavalcanico from Glen Floors.
We'd love to give you a tour of our showroom. Come on in, follow us.
Glen Floors was founded almost 90 years ago and is still owned and operated by the Capobianco family and their loyal employees. We supply and install carpeting and flooring from some of the most popular and designer manufacturers. The finest in imported wools, our natural carpet selections such as sisal and jute,
pet-friendly choices,
luxury hardwood flooring, and the latest in waterproof vinyl clip flooring. Our 5,000 square foot warehouse is where all our fabrications, inspections, and installation preparations happen. Together, the Glen Floors team works to oversee every project and its progress from start to finish. We are here, we are open, and we are ready to serve you, our local community, and beyond.
That was a commercial produced right here in our downtown, our Glen Cove downtown bid office. With each event and program that the bid produces or initiates, a press release is written and sent to the press. And we do make headlines. This year, we celebrated the opening of Village Square, welcomed new residents, and welcomed 6 new businesses. The next video, please. Okay, I apologize, another video that's not working. We work closely with property owners, realtors, and potential downtown businesses to help promote all the downtown has to offer and to assist with any business-related things we can. We work with the building department and the CDA by providing information on the grant programs, such as the sign and facade grants. These are a few businesses that the CDA assisted in grants. Can we go back to the previous slide? I'm sorry, yes. Okay. Our military and veterans are very important to us. Last year we started the We Honor Our Veterans, an initiative that we continue to build on at present. Over 35 downtown businesses have this decal in their windows, signifying to military and veterans that the businesses offer a discount. Special events have always been a specialty of the BIDs. During the pandemic, we had to invent different ways to produce these events while keeping our community safe. Our Downtown Sounds Committee consists of Fred Guarino, Francine Kohler, Fred Demina, Keith Way, Tony Kessel, Mary Cooper, Pat McLaughlin, Epi, and Deputy Mayor Maureen Basdavanos. Our Downtown Sounds Committee introduced virtual downtown sounds. I am hoping this video works. Our Downtown Sounds Committee introduced virtual downtown sounds. With this, we were able to keep music in our downtown area. We purchased with 3 large flat screen TVs and sound bars that were rolled out every Friday by DPW and placed around the downtown eateries so that their customers could enjoy a COVID safe live concert. Fred Guarino of Tiki Recording Studios and the Downtown Sounds chairperson formed a production team for our virtual downtown sounds. I hosted the concert at Tiki Recording Studio, and the artists were at Dear Studios. I was able to interact with the artists and with followers on Facebook. Each concert had about 3,800 viewers from around the world. One of the best parts about this virtual concert was we were able to highlight our local businesses during the concerts with one of our commercials we created or were provided. Please see an example of this.
Thank you very much. Now, once again, that was Kim Dell singing that. And now, a word from our sponsor.
I have to say, I think everybody will agree, the Doobie Others sound amazing. So don't go anywhere. They will be right back. And don't forget, we welcome your kind comments. Just go to the Glen Cove Downtown BIDs Facebook page and make your comments under the live performance. While the Doobie Others take a short break, let's have a few more messages from our Glen Cove Downtown businesses. We give special thanks to our virtual downtown sound sponsors, Beth Page Federal Credit Union, Men on the Move, Phillips Little LLP, our virtual downtown sounds team, Ray Lambies, David Merrill, Fred Guarino, Michael Epstein of Dear Studios, Tony Kessel, and Keith Waite. Our Young Downtown Sounds volunteers are very important for us, and we thank Ava Boyer, John Bablo, Dominic DeChera, and Alicia DeChera. Last year, we introduced a new event, Fitness in Village Square, but due to the pandemic, we were not able to have it on the dates that it was originally planned. But with careful planning and using COVID-safe guidelines, we were able to launch it in October. This event took place in Village Square, October through November, highlighting our fitness businesses while getting our community moving in a free workout every Saturday morning. As our downtown streets and businesses were preparing for the holidays, we were uncertain if we would be able to celebrate the holidays with our community. But when our plan to have Santa come to town was approved, we could not have been happier. Our downtown Santa Tony Tripp built a gilded frame that held plexiglass. This allowed our community to visit Santa safely. Zavavia did an incredible job decorating Santa's den. Candy canes, popcorns, and Christmas ornaments were given out courtesy of American Paving and Masonry. We had Christmas carolers, and the city lit up the first Christmas tree in the new Village Square. It was wonderful seeing people in our community, and I thank everyone for keeping each other safe by wearing masks. Were we able to put the video on? We thank our Santa is Coming to Town sponsors, American Paving and Masonry, and Savavia. Our Santa, Tony Tripp, our Christmas carolers, Ava Boyer, Lexi Briones, and Kate Houghton. With much appreciation to our volunteers, the Briones family, and Sue Alfred. What are our plans for 2021? We are going to focus on economic development programs. We will continue marketing our downtown businesses via Fios and Channel 12 News, commercials, and through our social media. We are hopeful that we will be able to continue our special events and bring them back in a big way, including celebrating New Year's Eve in Village Square. The Glen Cove Downtown BID cannot accomplish these programs and events alone. We would like to give special thanks to Mayor Tenke, the City Council, Legislator DeRiggi-Whitton, Department of Public Works, especially Manny Grella, Keith Simpson, Elizabeth Mestres, Vinnie Martinez, Mario Caljone, Ralph Kemp, Caminto, Damian and Jim and Destin, the Beautification Commission, Police Department, Auxiliary Police Department, EMS, and the Fire Department. I have said over and over how proud I have been of our downtown businesses, how they have helped one another and transformed how they conducted business overnight, and how proud I am to be part of a community that supported our businesses. But there are a few people that have stood out in helping our businesses, and we feel it is only fitting to celebrate these people. When the Downtown Sounds Committee came up with virtual Downtown Sounds, we turned to Fred Guarino. Hi, Fred, are you there?
Hi there, I am here. Hi, can you hear me?
Yes. Fred Guarino, we turned to him for his knowledge and support. It started off being one performer on FaceTime from their home and turned into something much larger and much more professional. Each time I personally added a challenge, like being able to communicate with the band and the viewers on FaceTime, I first, of course, got the no from Fred, but a few days later, he rose to the challenge. Fred, on behalf of the Glen Cove Downtown BID, we present you this award for your extraordinary vision, compassion, and dedication for the betterment of our downtown. Thank you for all that you do for us.
Wow. Isn't that amazing how that could happen through a TV screen and modern technology? Wow.
It's like the Jetsons.
Incredible. So thank you so much for these honors. You know, we wanted to just do something to keep Downtown Sounds alive last year, something that was it turned out to be something different and something good for the community. I think our online interactive experiment worked because our viewership numbers were pretty successful. And this was a real test of human involvement during a difficult time, because we all saw the future. Our technical team, our crew, and our bands, they all wanted to embrace the challenge. And especially Patricia, who kept pushing me to do more and more and more, which we had to do. So I'm grateful to our technical team and, of course, to those that made it possible, Delia, DeRiggi-Whitton, Mayor Tim, and Deputy Mayor Maureen, and of course, Patricia, and the whole Downtown Sounds Committee. So thank you very much. And I hope we rose to the occasion. And I also hope we don't have to do it again. But we are
going to do it again with the live concert.
Okay. This will be what we call an enhanced concert, because it'll be perhaps the real live thing and maybe some components of what we've learned to do. So thank you. Thank you very much.
You're welcome, Fred. When many of our downtown businesses were clearly being left out of the PPP funding, Matt Nartowicz of American Community Bank came to the rescue of many of our downtown businesses, helping 38 businesses with the PPP loans, bringing about $1.4 million of funding in our downtown area. Not only did you help these businesses, Matt, but you sometimes help them within hours. Matt, hi there.
Hi.
You're kind of sideways.
Oh.
There you go, okay.
All right.
Matt, on behalf of the Business Improvement District, we present this award to you for your extraordinary support, compassion, and dedication for the betterment of our downtown. Thank you for all the help you gave our downtown businesses. And I will add that giving our businesses the contact, it kind of made me pretty popular around here.
Well, thank you so much. It's a wonderful honor. I'm very proud of what we did here and the team did for Glen Cove, and especially for the downtown BID. When I learned about this honor, I wanted to learn a little bit more about the BID and more of the board. And I took a look, and I've known so many of you a lot from this past year, but some of you for a lot longer, like Ann Fangman from the CDA and the CDA team. And from there, I got to meet Michael, Maureen, and then Mayor Tenke. I've known Fred Guarino and Leonard Gleicher for years. And more recently, I got the chance to meet with Alvin Batista, Elisa Coons, Charles Parisi, John Zozzaro, and Anthony Garcia. So for the other people I don't know the board, I hope to get to know you very well in the near future. And my staff who lives here in Glen Cove always says, once you live in Glen Cove, you never leave. Well, I don't live in Glen Cove, but I have worked here for the last 11 years. And I want to thank the downtown BID and all of the businesses that I love to frequent for making me feel here at home. So thank you, and thank you for this great honor.
Thank you, Matt. Council, when many people took cover at the start of the pandemic, Councilwoman Danielle Fugazy Scagliola went into gear with helping the families of our community at the Glen Cove High School food pantry. She stayed in constant contact with me, concerned about our downtown businesses and wanting to help in any way she could. At first, there was not much one could do but offer moral support, and this she did by reaching our downtown businesses in a letter of support. Danielle, I would like to see you, Danielle, but if I just have to see the City of Glen Cove emblem. here she comes, okay.
Hi there.
Hello there.
How are you?
Good, good. So Danielle, you have helped with the BID's proposal of closing the streets in the downtown area for the restaurants, lighting up School Street with the string lighting, fitness in Village Square, bringing Santa to downtown Glen Cove, and so much more. Danielle, you are always here for the BID. It is not about photo opportunities for you or taking credit for anything that you do. It comes from your heart and the concern that you have for the Glen Cove community. Danielle, on behalf of the Glen Cove Downtown BID, we thank you for your extraordinary support, compassion, and dedication for the betterment of our downtown.
Thank you for this wonderful award. Patricia, thank you so much for the honor and the recognition. I've been a member of the BID for over 10 years now, and I've been on the board for about 4, and I'm really proud to continue after I'm sworn in again tonight. I'm very humbled by this honor because I'm really in great company. My fellow honorees have worked very hard to help the businesses in our downtown, whether it was helping with the PPP loans, like Nick, I think you said like 38 loans. It's so amazing. Or, you know, like John and Fred and others on the BID who look for ways to improve things, not just for themselves, but for all the business owners. I can remember John Zozzaro, if somebody needed a table for outside dining, he said, I have tables, just come take them. You guys are really true assets to the community. And I thank you all for everything that you guys do. As you said, Patricia, you know, everybody knows that last year was not easy for our businesses. And I, the mayor and the whole city council really wanted to make sure we did things that would make lives a little bit easier for the business owners in such a hard time. And I'm really happy that we were able to close the streets for outdoor dining, which I think we are planning to do indefinitely when the weather permits.
Yes.
It makes me so happy to see the downtown lit up with those new lights, thanks to your hard work and DPW. I can't wait to see that continue through Glen Street. And, you know, we continue to work on things, right? We're working on the parking and we're working on those directional maps to make it easier to navigate for out-of-town visitors. I really feel like our downtown is a real vital part of Glen Cove. And my hope is that we can continue to make improvements and make the place come to life. I appreciate the hard work that everyone on the BID does, which is a volunteer board, and that people give so much. The city, the folks in the city that keep things going, like Mayor Tenke and Deputy Mayor Basdavanos, Ann Fegman, the DPW, and of course, Patricia Holman, who I have to say, like me, comes up with a new crazy idea almost every day.
This is true.
Put us her way to get something implemented. So I really do appreciate that. And I look forward to continuing to work together on the BID and to make Glen Cove downtown a great place for all of our community to enjoy. Thank you, everyone, for everything you do. I appreciate it. And thank you for this great award. I really do appreciate it.
Thank you, Danielle. And thank you for
always answering every time I called with one of my crazy new ideas.
Well, a lot of people get those calls from me, so no worries.
Okay. When the restaurants were ordered to only offer takeout and delivery, John Zozzaro of Downtown Cafe was always one step ahead with his creative ways of doing and staying in business. During this pandemic, John evaluated the situation and thought outside of the box to ensure that his restaurant survived. Each and every time John did something for his restaurant, he shared his knowledge with neighboring restaurants. It is through John's insightfulness that we had a meeting with Legislator Delia DeRiggi-Whitton regarding the large fees that third-party delivery services charge to restaurants struggling during the pandemic. John, you have been available and helpful with the street closures, the string lighting on School Street, the parking garage, and much, much more. On behalf of the Glen Cove Downtown BID, we thank you for your extraordinary vision, support, and compassion for the betterment of our downtown.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
There you go.
I must have a weak internet connection. Okay, here it is. I finally got it. There you go.
It was just slow. It was a snail mail. Yeah,
exactly. No, thank you so much. It's an honor to have this. And it's basically everybody helping each other out. And especially now during the pandemic, we all had to step in and try and do our best to make business happen, make everything work. We had a lot of help. Everybody on the bid board was tremendous. The city of Glen Cove letting us eat outside and outdoor dining, trying to go get ahead, like you said, be ahead of the curve and doing it right. And we did it and we implemented it well. And I hope it's something that's here to stay. You know, sometimes through bad things, you get good things out of it. And hopefully something like that with street closures for all the restaurants, it was a helpful thing. And I want to thank you for this. And thank you for everything that everybody else does. Thank you.
Thank you, John.
Thank you, Patricia.
You're welcome. Now, I would now like to welcome the initiator of the Glen Cove Downtown Business Improvement District, former mayor of Glen Cove and current U.S. Congressman Tom Suozzi.
Hey, everybody. I'm happy to be with all of you, and congratulations to the four honorees. It's really wonderful. And congratulations to you, Patricia, and to the whole board and all the great work that everybody's doing in the bid. And listen, it's been a very tough year for all of us. The pandemic has been cruelly uneven. Some people completely unscathed. Some people working remotely, still got their jobs, getting their paychecks. Nobody got sick. Other people got sick. Some in their family died. I lost my father-in-law, 92 years old. Died within 36 hours of getting the coronavirus. Other people, you know, some businesses are fine, you know, some businesses, you know, online retail and all kinds of successful businesses that are unscathed because the people are working remotely, and other ones are just wiped out. Catering halls in big trouble, live entertainment venues, airline industry. Some people are, you know, it's just uneven. So the downtown is such an important place, as you all know. People define a community by its downtown. You go down Cedar Swamp Road, you go down Forest Avenue, they're pretty active with the strip malls. They have a lot of tenants. There's a lot of turnover there. If our downtown is not vibrant, people say, what happened to Glen Cove? It's fallen apart. And Glen Cove's downtown was really in trouble when I first became mayor. And people who drive through the downtown and see the lights that you're talking about, or the flowers, or the scarecrows, or the banners, or the businesses that are doing well, or the nice storefronts, they say, wow, Glen Cove's really coming back. So Glen Cove's downtown is one of the most important marketing pieces for the entire city of Glen Cove. People don't drive through our neighborhoods. They don't see the waterfront. They don't see the beaches. They don't see Morgan Park. They see the downtown. And the downtown is how Glen Cove is defined. And so when I was mayor, we talked about how we could know, if we had all the businesses on Cedar Swamp Road and Forest Avenue, all in our downtown, we'd have the most vibrant downtown in the United States of America. But our downtown is challenged because you're not going to the downtown unless you're going to the downtown. But a lot of people, 50,000 car counts, drive down Glen Cove Road up to the firehouse, make a right, and just bypass the downtown. That was actually the plan of the arterial highway when my father was the mayor in the 50s, because the downtown was too congested and there were tenement apartment buildings. And they said, oh, we got to fix the traffic. So they diverted the traffic from the downtown. Well, now the downtown, you don't go unless you're going. So we have to have destinations, reasons to come to the downtown. That's why Staples as an anchor is so important. That's why Safavia is important. That's why the restaurants that are so popular are so important. That's why the downtown sounds is so important, not during coronavirus, obviously. People coming to the downtown for something they want to go see. That's why the apartments are going to make a big difference, I think. Hopefully bring a lot more activity, street activity, once the pandemic is over. So the concept behind the downtown when we first did it was we're competing against malls and strip centers. And what do malls and strip centers have? They have a mall manager or a strip center manager. And that person's responsible for making sure the place looks nice and making sure that the snow gets plowed. Someone just complained to me that they're not doing a good enough job cleaning the snow off the sidewalks and making it easy to cross from your car parked onto the sidewalk. So we got to work on that. We make sure that there's things that are attractive about the area, and they try to lease out the empty spaces. Patricia and I talked about that with Danielle the other day, about trying to identify where are the places we need to rent, where are the places we need to try and identify to make them look nicer, and set up the top five list of each and go after them and get all of our community to work together to get those places looking better and rented. So I love Glen Cove. I know how important the downtown is. I was in the downtown today, went down to get something framed by Tony Gallego. I'm going down to Washington tomorrow. I know most of you that are being honored, most of you that are on the board. I'm grateful for all of you. And I am fighting hard in Washington, D.C. to bring money back to Glen Cove and to New York and to my district every single day. And anytime we can do anything to help you, please just call me or call Cindy Rogers, who's my district manager, who's on this call, also Glen Cove. She was my first deputy mayor when I was mayor of Glen Cove. She's now the district manager of my congressional office. If we can help you with PPP or help you with EIDL or help you to navigate the bureaucracy, or if there's something you want me to try and work on to help you, please let me know. My cell phone is 516-404-9672, 516-404-9672. Or you can call my Huntington office. So I love Glen Cove. Let's keep fighting together to make it as best it can possibly be. Let's figure out how to get more tenants in the downtown and how to make it always look nice and make it help our landlords and our tenants as much as we possibly can. All right, thanks very much, everybody.
Thank you, Congressman Suozzi. I'm sorry?
And congratulations to the honorees.
Thank you. And Congressman Suozzi did send beautiful citations for all the honorees that in which they received. And I just want to thank you, Congressman Suozzi, for always taking the time, for being here for the bid, and all that you are doing for our small businesses in Washington.
Thank you. You heard today the president announced today that the PPP program, the payroll protection program, is going to be focused on businesses with 20 employees or less, solely the employees with 20 employees or less for the next 2 weeks. So now's the time to go to the American Community Bank or any other bank that you deal with to try and get a PPP loan for a small business, 20 employees or less. All right, thanks everybody.
Thank you. Senator, we now have words from Senator Jim Gorin.
Hi, this is State Senator Jim Gorin, and I am up in Albany this evening, so I cannot join you. However, virtually, I just want to congratulate the city of Glen Cove and the downtown bid for all the great work that you are doing. As senator for this district, I am amazed at how many times I have been going back to Glen Cove during this pandemic and seeing new businesses opening and so many entrepreneurs getting ready to take advantage. What I hope is going to be a much better this year than we had last year. And so I have submitted some proclamations as a small token just to say how much the state of New York is appreciative of the bid and the city of Glen Cove led by Mayor Tim Tenke and what they're doing to rebuild Glen Cove. So thank you so much.
Legislator Delia DeRiggi-Whitton had to jump, unfortunately, onto another Zoom meeting. But I just want to mention that over the last 2 years, Legislator Delia DeRiggi-Whitton has been responsible for a total of 35,000 grants for our downtown sounds from the Nassau County Hotel Motel Grant Program. She has also been responsible for several revitalization grants for capital improvements in our downtown area. I know that Legislator Delia DeRiggi-Whitton wants to wish the best for our honorees. They all received beautiful citations from her office. I would now like to welcome our mayor, Timothy Tenke. Oh, Delia's here now. Delia came back. Hi, Delia.
Hi. I'm so sorry. My daughter just moved me, Ariana. Thank you, baby.
I just said some wonderful things about all that you do for downtown. I'm sorry you missed it.
Yeah, well, you didn't have to do that, but I appreciate it. Should I say a thing or two? Where are you?
Yes, of course.
Okay. Well, I just want to congratulate you, Patricia, because you really, when we needed you, you were there, and you really came up with some creative ideas to handle a very, very difficult situation. And I'm very proud to work with you, and I'm very impressed with your upbeat way of handling making lemonade out of lemons, and you've really done it once again. And I just want to mention a couple of things very quickly. Tony Kessel, we will be putting in for another grant for Downtown Sound. I guess you would imagine that, like everything else, the hotel motel money is a little bit scarce this year, but we're going to do what we can to get, to get whatever we can. And I just wanted to also mention that working with John Zozzaro on the legislation to limit the amount that different delivery groups such as Grubhub and Uber Eats charge was a real highlight. We did not, unfortunately, the presiding officer would not call the legislation as of yet, but we had incredible media coverage, and I think a lot of people became aware of how much. Is actually charged, whereas 50-40% go to the delivery and the dinner, they make like less than 10% on the budget. So I also want to thank you, Patricia, for helping people with the PPP applications. We really have to hit it hard this year. There's going to be a lot more available for restaurants. I really hope so. And I know Mayor Tenke and I have also worked hard to see what we can do with getting a vaccine location once we're allowed to have. The problem has been, and you're going to hear it, it's supply and demand, and Nassau County is now up to 5,000 a week, which is a lot better than where we were. We were 2,300 a week. So we're slowly but surely getting there. Right now, believe it or not, I don't have the okay to just go ahead and vaccinate seniors. We tried to get that to be part of the Office of Aging obligation to help seniors, help get them to get these appointments. So I've met with someone from the administration today, and we're trying to set up a way that we can have the seniors get assistance to get these appointments. Right now, they might have to have another underlining condition, but between high blood pressure, any type of pre-diabetic, all these different conditions, probably many of our seniors would qualify for that. So we're going to try to do what we can to make the appointment process being easier. And then once I really think the game changer is going to be once Johnson & Johnson's on board. You know, the mayor and I have also spoken about having, you know, really lobbying for a local location. So we're hoping, and I'm really sorry that it's been such a frustrating process for everyone, but there is hope on the way. I'm a big believer in spring is coming, and I have to say, if one thing this pandemic has shown us is how much Glen Covers really love being with each other, and the downtown sounds and the Morgan Park concerts and car shows and dining out, it's just such a big part of our culture now. And Patricia, you and the BID have really been a huge part of that. And I thank you. It's one of those jobs that we have that you have to be born for it, and you were, and we're very grateful to have you and your staff.
Well, thank you so much. That means a lot to me. You're actually going a little bit in and out, but thank you for all the kind words and encouragement that you gave me. And thank you for all the work you're doing, especially with the seniors and getting the vaccination for them. And I will just add, the Downtown Sounds, getting a Downtown Sounds grant was a big surprise. Didn't know that was coming, but we welcome all the funding that we get, because this year I am hopeful we will have a Downtown Sounds concert, hopeful, cross our fingers, and we're going to do it big. So hello, Mayor Tenke.
Look, first of all, can you hear me?
I can hear you fine.
Okay, terrific, because I was having some problem with my audio. All
right. I see you're sporting a new look here.
Well, you know, this is when the bit's over, it'll be gone. let me just say, Patricia, you know, thank you so much for everything that you do for our city. You really go above and beyond and trying to make sure that our downtown remains vibrant, and there's interest in our downtown for people to come and visit it. So for me, to see what this town is going through in the last year, I mean, it was new for me. It's certainly new for all our businesses and for you as well as your board. But my goodness, the fact that they pulled together and worked together and did so much good for our downtown, it was really just unbelievable. And like I said, I think Danielle and I think you were there too early on last, I think end of March or early April. We walked around to the shops and we, you know, see how they were doing. And I was glad to see so many of them were still open, you know, which was very, very encouraging. But, you know, your board and you really make sure that our downtown is really working the way it should. And we can always use improvement. I'm not saying that it's perfect right now, and we can always do better. But, you know, with the new lights that we have down there and the parking adjustments that we're going to be making downtown, and the fact is that we're going to be bringing those string lights over onto Glen Street very shortly. And we have the businesses. You know, the senator alluded to it earlier that, you know, where other downtowns are closing businesses, we're opening businesses, which is so encouraging for our downtown, because people realize and they recognize that Glen Cove is growing, and we're going to have people coming here, and we do have people coming here. Our Village Square right now is filling up, and that's going to be bringing more people to downtown. And Carlo of La Busla said to me, if it wasn't for them being there, he doesn't know if he would have made it, having extra people downtown. And that's what I love about our people that live in this community. They do support especially when it counts, to go downtown and support our restaurants. I know John Zozzaro appreciated the people coming down, and all the other businesses that we had down there. And you know, we John, you said this earlier. We closed the streets, but opened it for restaurants. And I think we're going to make that a permanent thing for our downtown. I think we're going to be looking to do that for the summer months and the nice weather, School Street and Glen Street, for pretty much like the same, the times that we did it during the pandemic. I think people really liked that. They were able to walk around downtown. It brought a lot of people into our downtown. And I think that, you know, if we can increase people to come down there and enjoy themselves and to visit our stores, our shops, our restaurants, it's worthwhile doing. And I look at that, and I think it does help for our downtown. And I'm hoping that the other shops, you know, may want to stay open a little longer, maybe take advantage of that, and see if they can, get a little boost in their economic situations as well. You know, Glen Cove used to be the cultural, economic, and entertainment hub of the North Shore of Long Island, you know, of Nassau County. And we used to have so much here. We're starting to bring that back. And I see that happening. But we need to stay on top of it. And with the ideas that Patricia has and the board has, and you know, I know you guys raise money, but you're spending it well. And I think, you know, making the downtown look beautiful, as Congressman Suozzi said, it really is. People judge what Glen Cove is about when they drive through our downtown and they see, you know, it doesn't look good. Are the stores full? And we're starting to see that they are. And anything I can do to help that and to promote that, I certainly will do. We're waiting now for this for the federal government to pass this $1.9 billion COVID bill. That I think once we get this some of that money back into Glen Cove, we can also help. And I know people are really living and they're waiting for this because they're running out of funds that they had gotten from last year. And we really need to make sure that they get taken care of. I just want to go over a couple of other things. The outdoor dining, downtown sounds, I'm all for, Patricia. If we can get that going again, that would be
fantastic. We're going to get it going again.
You know, Ann Fangman has been working very hard on our downtown also with the sidewalk project. And also we have the engineering looking at the access to the parking, the Brewster Street parking garage from School Street. I also want to take out some of the bump outs down there to increase some parking on School Street because we need it. We definitely need some additional parking down there. And then, you know, there's a lot of people that use it. There, you know, people using it for the medical buildings, for the west side of School Street, also for the east side of School Street. We have businesses there. So any way we can increase that, we will do that. And you've been definitely working on our downtown areas with these projects. So I'm very happy to see that those are moving along. And I'm hoping that by next year, I mean, I know this, we're already into February, but, you know, the engineering reports get done and we can start looking at, you know, doing stuff for next year. We also have some improvements going on in the garages. The Brewster Street garage on the top floor is going to get repairs so it doesn't leak and it doesn't continue to deteriorate. Those are all things that will benefit our downtown. The lighting downtown has been improved. The pergola next to Noble Savage is going to be put in this year with some benches to dress that area up as well. So we're really looking to make the downtown as vibrant and as exciting and, you know, as inviting as possible. Like I said, I also just want to take a few minutes and say thank you to those four people that that were honored this evening for the work that you did this past year. And you really do deserve it because you went above and beyond during a time when it was very difficult to do anything. And you made Glen Cove still a vibrant place by doing that. I mean, Fred, thank you for the downtown sounds. That was terrific. Matt, with getting some funding for our businesses downtown so they can survive. You know, Danielle, with you pushing, she's constantly pushing me to get things done in the downtown, which is her job, you know. But she does do that. I want to say thank you to Maureen, my deputy mayor, also constantly pushing to make sure things get done in our downtown area. And let me see, who else was one of the honorees? We had John, Fred, Danielle, and Matt. And Matt. Right, so I got all four. Right.
You got all four.
It was really, really wonderful that you guys, you know, and that just shows the nature of Glen Cove, how we look out for one another here in Glen Cove, and we care about one another. And I really hope that going into 2021 this year, we're going to start seeing improvement. Already the numbers are coming down, and let's hope they continue to come down. And I know Delia was talking about it, getting a vaccine error. We're really working on it. I work on that every single day. And I'm hoping that very, very, very soon we'll have a spot nearby in Glen Cove, if not in Glen Cove, to start administering some vaccines to the people in Glen Cove. So just stay tuned for that and listen for that, because as soon as I have that news, I will make sure that it's out there and people are aware of it. So that's something that's very important. But that's it. I think, I mean, my goodness, so there's a lot going on. I mean, our Christmas time in downtown was spectacular, Patricia. Thank you for that. I mean, the Village Square, Lisa, you were there. I mean, with RXR, it was really, really beautiful. The way we had, it decorated, we had the tree donated by a resident here in Glen Cove, and everything, it looked beautiful. And what a spirit lifting type of event that we had that people really needed at the end of the year. And I think that was really, really a wonder. I felt great about it. It was really wonderful that we were able to do that. So we keep up these events. We keep up making our downtown look beautiful. And hopefully all these things will pay off. And John, you were right when you said that out of the bad, there's got to be some good that comes out of it. And I think keeping the streets closed going forward for our summer seasons and stuff will be a benefit that we'll get out of this as well. So instead of talking all your ears off, I'm going to turn it back over to Patricia. But I do want to say thank you to all of you. And I know I have to swear some people in.
Yes, you do.
I will do that when Patricia tells me to do that.
Okay. Before you do that, I just also want to thank you, Mayor, because it has been a difficult year. And we never knew what the next day was going to bring us. But I know I jumped up and down about several of the initiatives, but in the end, we got the street closures, we got the lights, and we were able to celebrate the holidays and have fitness in Village Square. So yes. I thank you for listening. Congressman Suozzi mentioned that somebody complained about the snow, and I just want everyone to know that Mayor Tenke heard us and he got that done. The snow was removed from our downtown. So
I can't stop the storms from coming, but we did. After that big one, it was a mess in our downtown, and I had the DPW come in and take all that snow out of there. So I hope that helped. I really do.
It did help, and it made our businesses and their potential customers quite happy after that was done.
So now,
Mayor Tenke, we have many members of our board here, and they're waiting to swear in. This year, we are welcoming Tony Garcia from Garcia Muay Thai as our board member. So the floor is yours. Right. Go ahead.
So what we're going to do is, whether you're standing or not, you don't have to. I'm going to ask you to raise your right hand. Okay. And then repeat after me. You say, I, and then state your name. I. State your name.
Anthony Garcia.
Do solemnly swear.
Do solemnly swear. Swear.
To uphold the Constitution of the United States.
To uphold the Constitution of the United States.
The Constitution of the State of New York. And the bylaws of the BID, the Glen Cove BID.
And the bylaws of the Glen Cove BID.
Okay, and then I will faithfully execute the duties.
I will faithfully execute the duties
of the position to which I am appointed or voted.
Of the position,
to which I am appointed.
To the best of my ability. So help me God.
So help me God.
You are all sworn. Congratulations. Wonderful. Best of luck to you. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Welcome aboard, Tony.
Yes, Tony, welcome.
Thank you.
So please do not end the meeting until you see an important message from our downtown businesses. I congratulate our 2021 Board of Directors. I look forward to working with all of you again and our new member, Tony Garcia, during 2021. I thank our guest speakers, Congressman Tom Suozzi, Senator Gorin, Legislator Delia DeRiggi-Whitton, and Mayor Tenke. We thank you all. We also thank you all for attending. And remember, especially in these times, it is very important